This is Jim Emter, Van Onen Company, Alexandria, Minnesota, with your closing grain and livestock comments for March 21st, 2018. Corn market today up a half to down a half. Soybeans up 1.5 to 2. Chicago wheat up a half cent. Minneapolis down 3 to 4.75. Kansas City wheat down 3 to 4.5. Markets right now treading water, for lack of better terms. We stand 1 week from the March planting intention report. A lot of talk out there about what those acres could be. We're leaning more towards an 89.5 million acre planting number for the corn market and a 91.5 for the soybeans. That's where we stand at this point. We think the bigger number for corn could come in the stocks number, where we could see a pleasant surprise to the upside in regards to maybe less stocks around the marketplace than the market's thinking right now. We'll have to watch that very closely. The stocks number is always a wild card and one we'll need to watch coming into that report. But for right now, with this reduction of 20 cents in corn, soybeans sitting about 30, 40 cents off the highs off the front month, only really about 10 cents off the highs for new crop. And with the Kansas City wheat nearly 80 cents off the highs, you've got to begin to look at these markets, and we view them as more of a, hey, we're approaching support points, begin to look at reownership against sales that have been made, and looking for target for end users to be maybe a little more aggressive here in the meal and corn market specifically. Again, details we cannot express to specifics, but feel free to give us a call and we'll help you step through that a little bit. We like the opportunity that these markets can provide. We've been running some numbers on carryout scenarios, and surprisingly, the corn carryout's getting a little tight for next year based off trend line yields and that 89.5 million acre planting number. So you're going to want to be attentive and alert here. I think it's going to be a pretty wild spring summer here as you work ahead. So do not count any of these markets out at this juncture. The feeder cattle market here down $1 to $1.50. Live cattle down 82.5 to 187.5. And the hog market down 67.5 in the front. June was up 47.5 and kind of mixed in the rest of the months. The cattle and hog market's really searching for a bottom right now, and for lack of better terms, we just haven't found one yet. We're nearing the third price counts in each of these markets. We think that should at least slow liquidation. But if we have a negative cattle on feed report or a hog and pig report, we could make that final push to a very rare fourth price count and then find the base of recovery from there. When you look at all cattle on feed, you're looking for about a 107 number here on Friday in regards to marketings and placements, right around 100%. Again, we'll watch that closely and set the direction. Cash will likely hold off very strong until that week, or I should say that I shouldn't expect too much cash activity, but that's what we'll be watching. The Fed FOMC rate today was increased 0.25 for the Fed interest rate. So we did get an increase there. The dollar index as a net result is lower today, and that could help export business. This has been Jim Emter, Van Onen Company, Alexandria, Minnesota. Trading in futures and options involves risk of loss and is not suitable for all producers. Past performance is not indicative of future results. This is a solicitation. Have a great day.